This is the second lesson for Laogar staff. That's the 10-foot, 3-meter staff behind me. Normally it's a single taper, so the width changes with the staff length. It's almost always made out of waxwood. I've never seen composite or ash or hickory or anything like that. As a note, you may wish to wear protective gear. This would be for your feet, and this is for your head. I find them hot and uncomfortable, and they don't really help much. Or you can wear a genuine Chinese head protector, which looks a lot like that. Or a simple baseball cap. What you're trying to do is not hit your head with the staff too hard. This isn't a Laogar length. This is more from a Wudang style, but it has the taper that's thicker than this. What's going on with this is you want the thin part of the staff always away from you. And what we're going to practice first is simply the starting move of this set. So we begin with the eyes level, the feet are together and pointed straight ahead. The left hand is along the outside. It's relaxed with the fingers down and the thumb forward and relaxed against the outside of the leg. The right hand is holding the staff with the thumb relaxed. You always want the thumb relaxed in this set so that if someone hits your thumb, it doesn't pin it and break it. That's your thumb move. These fingers are holding the staff. It's really 3 fingers. The little finger doesn't do that much. There are a lot of spins in this set. So what we have is the knuckles are forward, the thumb is on top, the palm is in, and this is at about halfway between the heart and the waistline. So the elbow is forming a right angle, and it's about a foot, 9 inches to a foot, outside of the tips of your feet. So if you drew a line across your feet, it's about 9 inches out here, and this staff should be vertical. So roll it, just to start it, you want to take a slight breath, inhale, and then relax the knees slightly. Nothing else has to do. Now what we're going to do, normally in the set, it's a lot simpler than this. What we're going to do to start, though, is use a short staff to get familiar with it. And then what we want to do is, this is going to have to come up like that in the set. It's even more difficult when the staff is longer, so we're going to start with a short staff. What we want to do is just simply raise this and put it down without looking, without crunching your foot. So it gets up and then down. It's about a 6-inch lift. What you then want to do is move your hand up slightly. You'll notice in the actual set, if you watch the films, what the Grand Master does is he drops his hand. It's going to actually lift the staff, but it's very quick, very subtle. He uses just a flick of the wrist. What we're trying to do is get this up off the ground about 12 inches without you hitting yourself. So what you want to do is have this hand on it. The first exercise is to just lift it like this. So you get the hand bowed up to eyebrow level. The right hand releases, the left hand just lifts it. And the next thing you want to do is leave the left hand up, but instead of pulling with that, open the left hand so it's like a tiger mouth. So it's guiding, it looks like more like the letter C perhaps. The thumb is in and on top, and it's open. So from the open, you're going to toss the staff up and then pitch it with the left and reset the right. What we want to do eventually is get this all the way up to here, where we have just a little space left here, and this is guiding. Where we're ultimately headed, though, with this is we want to not use the left hand. So what we're actually doing in the set with a short staff is the right hand goes down and the staff comes straight up. That's where we want to get to. You want anywhere from 0 to 6 inches down here. This hand is going to end up at heart level, and it's closer in against the body. It started out here, we brought it in, so that this isn't moving all over the place. With the actual Laogar staff, we're still with an angle here, right angle on the elbow, and this is fairly close in, lined on the front of the toes. So it's coming up like that. What we need drop the hand slightly, and then this comes up, so it's here. And what's going to happen in the actual set is we're going to turn to our left, opening the left foot, and then it comes up on the toes and comes out. Then this part, the staff, the thin part, comes down and touches softly, right? So then what's going to happen when we do that is there's a stress on the wrist. So you have to be careful with this when you're first practicing it. It's probably not a bad idea to guide this down so you don't sprain your wrist the first time you practice. So when we start up here, the left foot opens, steps out, this comes down. This is actually a block against the low strike, or it's a hit onto someone's foot. It can also be a rake down their face, but you really don't have that much power in one wrist. So it's more just a block. We're using the gravity to drop the tip of this. At that point, we're going to shift the weight back. So this knee straightens out pretty much. Most of the weight is going back on this hip, and this knee, still pointed forward, is going to flex. Right? So that this hand is here. The left hand hasn't done anything. So as we do that, what we want to do is step back, the left foot steps back. So it's a pair of half steps, step, step. Right? And as you do the step, step, this comes up, and the left hand helps it come up. So we're palm up, thumb relaxed. So we go step, step, up. This is a block up, snapping either whatever the weapon is, or into the guy's groin, or into his chin and face. Right? So, ba-boom. Then what happens is we take a big step left and we're impaling him or piercing as if this were a spear. Because you can actually do this set with spear pointing in, I'll show you that later. But this is a lump, a pierce off of this. So the left hand winds up extended beyond this foot and beyond this knee. We're in an archer stance. This is, we're going to put it right through it. So that staff itself is parallel to the ground, about heart high. You're aiming right at him.